because I've never seen you open this late.
Yeah.
Are you just restocking?
No, we're just doing our thing.
What's just up? Doing your thing? What's yeah. your thing?
What's up?
Well, I've never seen anyone in the store this late.
Is that a problem?
Okay, pardon me?
No, just chill, chill. Is that a problem?
No, sir, there's no problem. I've never seen anyone in the store this late. I wanted to come check in and make sure
there's
everything's okay.
There's no problem going on.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are you guys restocking the store?
There's no problem going on.
Why are you here so late?
It does not matter.
It does matter.
To who?
To me.
Why?
Because the store's never open this late.
Is it your store?
No.
And then what? If it's not your store, what's the problem?
I don't have a problem, sir.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to know why you guys are here so late.
It does not matter. That's what I'm telling you.
It does to me. Can you take a hand in your pocket, please?
It does not matter to me.
Okay. Or one of you own the store?
Huh?
Do one of you own the store?
It does not matter. I'm not going to answer your question. If you have a problem, you tell me you have a problem.
I have a problem with you three being in the store right
is
now.
Is this your store?
Why.
That's what I'm asking you.
This town is my duty to protect.
This is... I live here. Do not... Tell
okay.
me about whatever.
That's fine.
Okay.
Where do you live?
I do not... I'm not going to answer your question. When your supervisor is here, you tell him to come talk to me.
Can you tell me who you are?
I'm not going to tell you who I am.
Why?
Because I'm not going to.
Why?
Because I'm not going to. Who are you? You
My name is Isaac.
Isaac. And then yes. what's your problem?
My business, sir, is to look at the property down here, and if there's something that stands out to me...
So what stands out to you? Like the three black people in a store?
There's three
so
people.
So you're going to... No.
Sir, you could be black, white, Hispanic...
No.
Absolutely, sir.
There's going to be three black people in a store. You're going to come around and try to, like, you know...
I don't want to argue. I just want you to tell me why you're here.
Here's what happened when the supervisor showed up.
Supervisor, how are you doing?
That's right, how are you doing?
You came, three of you guys. What's going on? What's the problem? There's three black people in the store. What's the problem with that?
So it's 1 o'clock in the morning. There's three people in the store.
There's three black people in the store. 3 o'clock in the morning. What's the problem?
There's three people.
There's three black people in the store. It's 3 o'clock in the morning. What's the problem?
It's 1 o'clock in the morning, and we never have any activity at the store at that time.
Okay.
Can you prove that it's your store?
I do not have to prove anything to you.
Actually, you do.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do.
No, I don't. To who and to why?
Oh, my God.
I do not have to prove.
You're looking out for our community.
Okay.
That's all we're doing.
Okay.
That's it.
You're looking out for my community. That's what you mean to say.
Do you want us to look out for your community?
I do.
Or do you want us to let anybody just walk in here at 2 o'clock in the morning and steal all your stuff?
I want you to look out for my community.
You sure?
Because
you don't sound like you're very grateful.
No,
you sound like you're very defensive.
No, no, no.
Come on now.
Calm
you're
down.
You're being very defensive.
No, calm down.
My officer is doing his job.
Your officer's not doing his job.
Yes, he is. He is following the policy of the chief of police at Tiburon PD and keeping his eye on Main Street.
Yeah, I want to wrap up this conversation. We're wasting time. So what's going on? What's up? What's the next step?
Prove to us that you have keys.
How is my store? Okay, wait.
That's a perfect thing.
I just asked for
that. Okay.
You know what? Put the key in the door and we're out of here.
Put the key in the door?
Put the key in the door.
I mean, just chill. I'm going to put my key in the door.
That's his store.
What's that?
That's his store.
Thank you very much. That's all I need to know.
My dude knows
Thank
me.
You. See ya.
Thank you for your time.
Can you put the key in the door first?
Huh?
Can you put the key in the door, please?
I'm not going to put the key in the door. He already
your
told you.
Chief of police is walking
away.
Done.
That's your supervisor.
Okay.
He said you walk away.
We're good.
The police eventually left because a white person down the street said, hey, that's his store. Hey guys, that's all we needed to know. Good, a good white man to vouch for you. We can move on with our day. Community safe. See what happened here, right? I guarantee you if another black male would have said, hey man, that's his store, the cops would not have responded the same way. Let's put up a picture of this couple. They're great people. They're remarkable people in their community. They have been awarded $150,000 because those cops did not, contrary to popular belief, they did not follow policy. Okay? Yema Khalif and his wife, Hawi Awash, are the owners of that store. It's a clothing brand. Okay? They received a $150,000 payment. Now, this is in California. All right? A portion of which they say will go to a scholarship fund they run through the store. They scholarship young people. The fund serves to educate orphaned youth in Ethiopia and Kenya. I told you they were good people. The couple, however, did not reach a settlement with the neighboring city of Belvedere, which also had an officer at the store that night. One of their attorneys said Belvedere's leaders were not up for the peacemaking and reform talks that those other cops were. The Tiburon police chief, Michael Cronin, let's put his picture up. Michael Cronin is on the left. Belvedere Sergeant Blasi is on the center. And another officer, his name is Isaac Mides. All right. So these individuals were responsive in that call, and they were inappropriate in their interaction. The police chief Cronin retired September 2020 amid backlash over the incident. Why? Because policy was not followed. The sergeant also resigned. The officers who approached, the officer that you heard approaching the couple that night remains an officer in that city. At the time, the couple were the town's only black business owners. Only. You don't think racism had anything to do with this? They were the only black business owners. The fallout from the August 2020 encounter shoved the quiet coastal enclave to the center of a racial justice movement that began just months earlier with George Floyd's murder. But after initially threatening a $2 million federal lawsuit, the couple says they were able to achieve meaningful reforms by staying out of the courtroom and directly engaging with the town officials. On Tuesday, the couple stood in front of their store announcing those reforms. Changes include police policy and training updates, as well as the formation of a citizens advisory panel to provide a forum between residents and the police. This advisory board would vet candidates for the department, and both Khalif and his wife secured spots on the board. Good for them. As part of the reforms announced Tuesday, officers are expected to begin carrying business cards with information about how to raise concerns over interactions. The police department has started a pilot program where community liaisons help residents with any police concerns or needs. The agency also increased the frequency of bias training from every 5 years to every 2. This is called a step in the right direction. They were able to achieve some things here because they initially said, we're going to sue, but we're willing to bypass the $2 million for a much smaller settlement. But you have to implement these reforms, okay? And reforms have been implemented, obviously. Obviously, you have to continue to watch over these reforms. Big ups to them for having the insight to create a citizens review board or an advisory board to oversee police conduct in their community. Kyla, what are your thoughts on this?
I am so glad that they are getting a settlement, because I think that racists should pay up. I'm starting to think that we should fine people for being racist on the grounds of emotional and generational suffering. And I want people to really pay attention to the fact that the officer said, oh, I'm looking out for the community. It's clear that he doesn't include Yema and his wife in that community that he's talking about, because how he approached them was aggressive and antagonistic. And it's simply, again, racism. White people by default are viewed as good people, and any actions that they take or to support or oppose that image are simply choices. Black people, on the other hand, are defined by our actions, and our choices deem us to be good or bad people, depending on who's looking. And we already know that the cops view us as violent. And so they approach him in an aggressive way because they already are assuming things about this gentleman. And so again, that racism that's wrapped in the system of policing that that officer showed, it needs to end, because that situation could have looked a lot different from Yema had that other man not spoken out and defended him.
That's right. And they would have simply claimed they feared for their life, even though the interaction was completely unwarranted. It was rooted in their own implicit and hyperaggression bias against black people. And this is the constant we deal with. And I know some people are going to push back when they see this on social media. They're going to say things like, well, doc, he could have just proved that he was the owner. Let me explain that to you. I would not have proven a damn thing. I would have did exactly what this store owner did. You have no call that my store is broken into. I don't need to prove a damn thing to you. And here's the equivalent of that. Once again, this is the equivalent of saying, boy, show me your freedom papers. Wait a minute, we already have the freedom to be mobile. We have the freedom to be in whatever establishment we choose to, if that establishment has not filed a trespass order. So we can do this. There's no evidence of breaking and entering. There's no call of a burglary. There's no alarm going off. You have no reasonable cause here, none whatsoever. You simply see a black man walking into his own establishment, okay? There is a place where black folk, there's a time and place where black folk are now saying, we're tired of showing you freedom papers. We don't have to prove to you why we exist. We don't have to show you that we live at the apartment complex or we have a residence in the community or that we own the business, because you would not ask those things if our skin color were different.
Mm-hmm.